Remember playing a couple practice rounds with Payne when he would wear long pants and a baseball cap, and people would walk right by him without even asking for his autograph.
Right.
They didn't recognize him.
Khaki pants, a white shirt, and a
baseball cap.
Who is that guy?
He was incognito.
Right. Yeah, who's that playing with Tom over there? Oh, yeah. That's Payne. You see his swing.
That's not Payne Stewart. No way, that's Payne Stewart. He was very consistent through his whole life with his style of what he wore, the way he acted, the way he played. It was just, you know, just a traditional, stylish person.
How about wearing that NFL stuff there, the colors that he would come out with, and we'd all look at that and go, oh my God, I couldn't pull that one off.
I used to kid him, I said, what's it like? I know when you're in your world at the golf course, you feel great, you know, because everybody knows who you are and you're in your world. So what's it like at 7-Eleven when you gotta stop and get gas on the way home? I bet he got some funny looks then.
Make sure to fill up on those Wednesdays when he's in your practice room.
That's right. You don't get gas on Thursday to Sunday.
He was not averse to spending time on the range, though. You know, he wasn't just didn't just show up and go through the motions. He worked at it, though, too, for sure.
He had a lot of heartbreaking losses. I remember, you know, I always remember him and Tracy walking off at the Byron Nelson way off in the weeds. Remember when he walked way away after he lost?
Yeah.
And then he kind of figured it out. You know, I think it's kind of like golf, though.
Sure.
I mean, some of us figure it out a lot quicker than others.
Right.
It took me late in life, but he finally figured it out and started winning majors.
Right.
Sometimes you don't expect the, with a guy with his attitude and his prankster ability and his, you know, kind of like to laugh and have fun, how serious he could get. I mean, I remember watching him many, many times on the putting green, and Tracy would be out there with him, and she'd be setting those balls around in a circle, you know, like 40 of them, you know, he'd be putting, you know, just work around the circle, you know, putting 3 and 4 footers, and she'd be lining him up, and for hours together they'd do that. And he was deadly serious about that.
Right.
I mean, if he missed a couple, he was mad, I mean, just on the putting green. Number one, that's good teamwork there, he and his wife working together, and number two, he was working hard. I give him a lot of credit.